get that cause, man.
And don't make another video talking about how you so busy or why you can't come debate me. Because I ain't gonna come to you niggas. You niggas making videos about me. You niggas. Because you don't have no criteria. You only can teach what your masters allow you to teach. And your master's lightweight, nigga. And your master's lightweight, nigga. And your master's lightweight, nigga. What the fuck you gonna do to me? Nothing. You said our camp was not gonna happen. You guys gonna fall out. You guys gonna do this. Well, motherfucker, I'm still here. What the fuck you gonna do to me? Old man, Tahar, T-God, Gabor, Aramlock, Jason. You ain't fucking Ricard, you Jason, hoe ass nigga. And when I say, shut your punk ass up. Cause you ain't debating nothing. And you lucky mama here now, so I gotta control my language. Hey mama, give me a hug.
Shalom, my
Shalom,
brother.
Sister, shalom. Shalom, my beautiful sister, my mother. Shalom.
Yeah,
I got it. Damn, now I can't go in no more. It's all good. Damn, give me John 12 for
some just
this is the book.
It's gotta be nice now.
This is St. John, chapter 12, verse 42. These things
you,
said.
Hey, hold on. You niggas got your mama out here to hear the word? That's good. Your mama saying shalom? Better be careful with your tongue about who you talking about.
He didn't follow the order, op.
He didn't follow the order.
He didn't follow the order, op.
He didn't follow the order.
He didn't follow the order, op.
He didn't follow the order. Goofy ass. We got all this damn ties money and you niggas ain't got no school. You got that tight ass studio with that stanky ass couch. All these years you been out here teaching and you ain't got nothing to show? Now you telling niggas to celebrate Passover on your own. Don't come to New York no more. Why? Because you can't afford the damn hall? All that money you getting, you should be having, dude, you should be, Tahar, you bullshitting. Nigga, why you think if your daddies ain't saying nothing, why y'all saying anything? T-God ain't said a word. Aramlock ain't say nothing. Gabar ain't say nothing. So why y'all talking? And see, hold on, spiritual fathers, Tahar, T-God, why you ain't telling no man to fall back if you so much about order? You ain't about no damn order. You want some goddamn money orders. That's what you want. You the niggas that got a leash on your neck, not us. So don't get mad because you hoes and can't be your own man. A lot of you niggas can't leave GMS because you're cowards. You can't go teach on your own. You don't trust in Yahweh Shai. You need men to guide you. Shalom.
You got more on that?
You need men to guide you. You can't let Yahweh guide your steps because you have no faith.
All right, Shalom, Makim, first and foremost, we want to give all praises to
Yahweh, Ba'ashem, Yahweh Shai.
Double honors to the elders, the apostles, great millstone. Your honors to you brothers who are out there doing the work in sincerity and the truth. Now what you see on YouTube, man, you have a lot of guys, man, who you pop off at the mouth. You think this truth is a game, you're making jokes, and you're slandering guys, and you're coming against the men who even taught you. You have no type of respect. And by you not having respect for another brother or men who are out there doing the work, especially men who have taught you and shown you the way, you have no respect for Yahweh Shai. And you definitely have no respect for the Father, Yahweh. Okay? And the Lord is going to destroy you guys, man. You know what I mean? And one guy I want to speak on personally, I don't like this guy too much, man. And he goes by the name of Nazariah, man. You're a loudmouth, big fool, man. The Lord's gonna kill you, man. And you're not on the level, you know what I'm saying? And you do all this screaming, you do all these different things, for what? You're just yapping and making no sense. Then you look like a idiot on the camera, man. Then your last video, they are afraid to confess him. What are you doing? Just starting division? Then your dumb ass bring your old ass mama out there. What's your old ass mama doing out there in the cold? She need to be in a damn house, man. Who do some shit like that? And she over there yelling, preach! You know, proud of her overweight, reprobate baby. Screaming nothing. Just a damn shame, man. You are an excuse, man. You're nothing but but just a waste, man. And you know, really, nobody really wants to respond, but really, I respond because, hey, look, you're popping off at the mouth, you're speaking false doctrine. Hey, good chance to use the scriptures, you know? All right, go ahead.
Romans chapter 1, verse 28. And even as they did not like to retain the Most High in their knowledge, the Most High gave them over to a reprobate mind.
All right, you guys have a reprobate mind, man. Okay? That's why you the way that you are. You gonna say your masters are lightweight. Meanwhile, you're using the name Yahweh and Yahweh Shai that you learned from them. You're teaching the doctrines that you learned from them. Your style of teaching of even being out on the highways consecutively in the cold, in season and out of season, is what you learned from them by their example. Meanwhile, you call these men lightweight. That doesn't even make any damn sense. You're calling Yoda Rakai a whole-ass nigga. Then you use his government name. You have no respect, man. You know what I'm saying? And then you guys are weak, man. On a carnal level, you never do that to anybody's face. Ever. Ever. Ever, man. It's just crazy. And really, you guys are nothing but carnal. There's nothing spiritual about you, man. Nothing spiritual about you whatsoever. But now you have waxed worse and worse. You've been warned. And then instead, you continued on with it. Instead of just being wrong and repenting or just continuing to do the work. Letting the Lord deal with you. You make yourself an enemy towards the truth. And then you wax worse and worse, and now you have offended on a level that you really can't take back, man. Now it's death for you, man. And we end that year where the Lord gonna start killing you guys, man. And like I say before, me personally, I don't like you, man. You know? And as an example for the brothers listening, man, you see plenty of guys out here, man, who just have a lack of respect, man. They think this truth is a game. And it's not. It's not, man. You know what I'm saying? They, like I say, bringing your mom out there and all this stuff, man. What do you think this is, man? This is serious, man. You don't bring women out here and stuff, man. You don't do that. Brothers, that's why we have to endure, man. We have to stay humble. We have to be in this thing. You see how these men are? These men don't care about us, man. They don't care about even the men who taught them, man. And they're pushing for you to be cause division. That's why the scriptures say, mark them that cause division. Because all they're doing is saying, you scared. You scared to get kicked out the camp. You scared to come against the elders. You scared to say something. You scared to say something.
You the niggas that got a leash on your neck, not us. So don't get mad because you hoes and can't be your own man. A lot of you niggas can't lead GMS because you're cowards. You can't go teach on your own. You don't trust in Yahweh Shai. You need men to guide you. Shalaki.
You got more on that?
You need men to guide you. You can't let Yahweh guide your steps because you have no faith.
There's an order of doing things that the Lord showed us to the scriptures. If you have a disagreement, you go to your brother and you work it out through the scriptures. You don't just up and raise hell and make videos and do things that's out of order like these guys trying to teach you to do. They don't care about the little ones, man. They don't care about you, you know? So for brothers who even listen to it, if that thought is in your head, get that shit out of there, man.
All right, you had some? I keep reading on. 1 Timothy chapter 1, verse 28 again. And even as they did not like to retain the Most High in their knowledge, the Most High gave them over to a reprobate mind to do those things which are not convenient.
Exactly. So they're doing things which are not convenient, man. That's why they talking about Luke 3 and is not Mary. And that's why they coming out with, you can't call a man your master or anything like that, man. They're just bugging out, man. There is no order within that. Meanwhile, using the doctrine that the men taught them and strand, well, not even really that anymore. They're straying away from it. And but meanwhile saying they have the truth and we don't. But you're using the same thing. It don't even make sense, man.
And please read this for you.
Go ahead, bro.
2 Corinthians chapter 10, I'm going to just read verse 13. But we will not boast of things without our measure. All right? But according to the measure of the rule which the Most High have distributed to us, a measure to reach even unto you. For we stretch not ourselves beyond our measure, as though we reach not unto you, for we are come as far as to you, also in preaching the gospel of HaMashiach, not boasting of things without our measure. And that's what you guys doing. You're boasting of things without your measure. The Lord didn't give you that particular measure of knowledge. You know, going into Luke 3 and totally butchering it. You trapping yourselves in the scriptures, man. You grappling and you getting whooped, man. You know, you fighting and you submitting to Satan, man. You know, thinking that you got something that you don't have, man.
Yeah. Like I say, you're a fucking blinking light, dying light bulb going against the sun, man. You're nobody, man. But you think yourself to be somebody. That's what's wrong with you guys, man. You start getting puffed up, you think yourselves to be somebody, and then what happens? You fail, man. Just like you're doing now, you're just a bunch of failures, man. And now those little young guys under you, they subscribing, looking like failures just like you, man. They not even on a level because they don't get a chance to speak. They don't get a chance to do anything, so they sound halfway retarded and out the spirit when they try to break something down, man. Yeah, man, then you got this, you know, these guys, man. Like, what? You're not even, like, see?
Yeah, subscribing to Nasty Riot's madness, man.
Mm-hmm.
You know, but see, hey, you get mad because Elder Apostle Tahar won't respond to you. He too high on the level to respond to y'all, man. You know? But, I mean, we see that, man, and it makes us mad, and we want to respond to it, man. Yeah. You know? But like the apostle said, man, it's written in the scriptures that guys like you are gonna do this, man. They brush you off so like it's like you non-existent, man. You know what I'm saying? You
crying for attention.
Yeah, they heavyweights, man. You know how I mean, man, you dudes are irrelevant, man. And hey, and when I made that lesson, you know, with these brothers was there, when I made the lesson, ignore these scoffers, I wouldn't even talk about you, man. But it's the shoe fit, evidently.
Yeah,
you was a scoffer, and hey, this is how the spirit work, man. And really, what I meant by that is going back and forth with Jake on the comment boards, man. That's really what I meant. Of course, we gonna respond if guys going off on the doctrine, man.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I'm saying? But guess what? We keep it moving. Mm-hmm. You're not our primary focus, man. Scripture say
exactly.
We keep our eyes single, man. We focus on Yahweh Hashem Yahushua coming back, man, destroying this place, not clowns like you, man.
Yeah.
You know?
While using the signs that this brother handmade.
Yeah, that like the RFID me. Chip that I drew, you got that sign, man. And you got the chariot sign that I drew or whatever, you got that too. But I'm short circuit, man. I'll be that. I'll be crazy too. I'll be bugged out too. Scripture say we fools for Hamashiach's sake, man. I'll be that, man. And that happened to me in the truth because I was going off in the truth. Not because something wrong with the elder teaching, man. You niggas are demons, man.
Mm-hmm.
Hey, you know, but hey, the spirit gonna deal with y'all.
Good.
Romans chapter 1, verse 29. Being filled with all unrighteousness, fornication, wickedness, covetousness, maliciousness, full of envy, murder, debate, deceit.
Come debate us. Come debate us, man. Hey, bro. Hey, you got something to do with it. You bitch ass niggas ain't gonna come debate us. Cause we got the truth, bro. Shut your overweight ass up, man. You ain't gonna do shit. You don't know the scriptures. And who gonna come? What we got to debate you for? The scriptures tell you they full of debate. The scriptures tell you not to be a debater.
Right.
Okay? The scriptures are against debate. We show how lightweight you are, man.
Yeah, you might as well be in black unconsciousness, man. You might as well go with Sarnetta and Polite them.
IGBK and all that, and start some debates. Go with Sakari and start them damn debates, man.
And he siding with Sakari, so.
Oh, yeah. The guy you was condemning, Sakari, you siding with him now. It's funny how you guys are, man, because you don't have anybody over you. You have no order, so now all the fallouts get together to validate each other, to make us feel like we're right.
I gotta be right somehow.
You know, and no, you're wrong, man. And that's the thing about you guys, man. The scriptures against all that debate shit. The scriptures tell you to defend the gospel, which is what we do. When clowns like you come out with that BS, we defend the gospel. Unlike you, you just come against the doctrine, man. Like you guys, you come out and you want people to debate you. You want their damn attention, man. When really you ain't shit.
Con.
You and Nazariah, Big Nasty, you ain't shit.
Con.
Chase Blunts, you ain't shit.
Yeah.
Yashawan, you got that old demon on you. You old soft, big ass nigga talking about y'all a bunch of robots. Like, nigga.
See, I told you got a bunch of robots. All the bunch of them guys, a bunch of robots.
Shut up, man. Why you over there talking about Nazariah's wisest, best speaker and all that? Come on, man. Get out of here, bro. You guys are slow, man.
Yep. Y'all low level. And y'all followers, if people subscribe to that man, as y'all speaking, they ain't on the level, man.
Right.
And ain't no brother in GMS teaching that Gray Millstone is the burning bush, man. You know, and if a brother is teaching that, stop teaching that shit, man. We don't teach that.
That shit's off.
Yeah, Yahweh Shai, he was the angel in the burning bush, man.
Mm-hmm.
You know? But the Lord, hey.
I'm talking about, you know? Guys getting all personal. You call the elders whole ass niggas talking about the elders ain't got enough money to afford to pass over. And like, really, what does that have to do with anything, man? Really, you guys are special ed Israelites, man. All right? You're retarded Israelites. All right? And you're just out there making a mockery of yourself, man. You this, all right? You're handicapped Israelites, man. It's a handicap on your knowledge. You don't know anything, man. Go ahead.
Deceit, malignity, whisperers.
Mm-hmm. Whisperers. That's all you do, man. You get on the phone with Element, and Element tell you that you're right. Brother, that's right, brother. You're right for thinking that. Yeah, you know, you go with that BS, man. You know, all y'all are lost, man. And you have lost already. Huh. And you just don't know it, and you've been warned, and the Lord's gonna destroy you guys, man. Go ahead, bro.
Backbiters, haters of the Most High.
You hate the Most High, go ahead.
Despiteful, proud, boasters, inventors of evil things, disobedient to parents.
Disobedient to parents, backbiters, proud. Proud, that's all you are, man.
Come debate us, nigga. Come debate us, nigga.
Oh, and I'm talking about this guy was acting like he can't be touched. Like nothing can touch him.
I'm with a power that don't give a damn about that shit.
You know.
Yeah. I'm with a power that controls this shit, nigga. Hey, the Lord ain't with you, man. Hey, Nasty Ride, you listen to this, man, and Chase, you know. And Yashawan, man, the Lord ain't with y'all, man. And Tawabia and the rest of y'all, man. And Tawabia, I don't even know how you got involved in all this, man. But see, that's how them demons work, man. You know, you start siding with dudes just because you think they cool, man. You know, so them demons got all y'all, man.
Yep, you're going to be another pet monkey, all right? And you're going to be destroyed right along with them. You keep on, nigga. All right? And all you guys, you're going to be destroyed, man. There's just a plain thing about it, you know, because you loud mouth. It's just certain guys, man. You know, you can't be wrong, you can't be anything, but meanwhile you just go harder when you're wrong. You go even harder.
I got a
like Chase Blunts, nigga. I don't even know why you teaching,
right?
Why you even saying anything? They bringing up Instagram and photos of other brothers. And meanwhile, Chase Blunts is just doing the Masonic pose, grab the wrist, however he do it. He does that on every pose by a nigga behind him throwing a Baphomet. You know, man, telling Jake to pick the bag of money up, and here you guys are just going and going about that bullshit, man. Brothers who listening, let this be an example of how not to be, man.
This should put you in fear, man. Especially after you hear about what's done happened to that guy Tazamat, man. Go ahead.
I got a precept. Galatians chapter 5, verse 9 down to 10. A little leaven leaveneth the whole lump. Mm-hmm. I have confidence in you through the Lord that ye will be none otherwise minded, but he that troubleth you shall bear his judgment whosoever he be.
Mm-hmm. And you troubling guys, man. And that little leaven that you putting out there, that bullshit, it'll leaven the whole lump, man. So all them guys that subscribing to you, to our followers, like nobody really follow you, man, but a bunch of other reprobates, man.
Yeah, views ain't shit, man.
Yeah, views don't mean anything, man. Making their own brand and shit, austere. Upside down smiley face, man.
The Watchmen.
Yeah, with Chase Blunt's beats on there, man. You know, it ain't nothing spiritual about you. You ain't got nothing popping for you, man. Yeah, there's nothing popping for you guys, man, but death and judgment. That's what's coming to you. But when it start happening and the Most High start picking you guys off, man, Nazariah, you lose an arm or something, or you get a curse to where your big ass can't eat anymore, you know, that'll be torture to a big motherfucker like that. He can't eat. Oh, yeah, he'll be suffering, man. And the Lord will do stuff like that to you, man. Go ahead.
Back in Romans chapter 1, verse 31. Without understanding, covenant breakers, without natural affection, implacable, unmerciful.
Right, unmerciful, man. I mean, you over here, just, you pop off at the mouth, man. Brothers done told you to repent. Because I include myself and all them guys in Chicago trying to work with you, man. But meanwhile, where's your mercy towards brothers, man?
Yep. Them brothers in Chicago was merciful to y'all, man. You know, you just couldn't be wrong, though. The scriptures say, he that being often reproved, hardened of his neck, mm-hmm. shall suddenly be destroyed, and that without remedy. You were being reproved, but you didn't want to receive it, man. So now you're going to be destroyed.
Yeah, man. You over with, man. You're done. And this video is mainly to be an example, man. An example. To the other brothers, hey, look at these pathetic special ed niggas out here just speaking dumb shit. You know? Excuse my language. Go ahead.
1, verse 32. Who knowing the judgment of the Most High, that they which commit such things are worthy of death, not only do the same, but have pleasure in them that do them.
Right, you guys are worthy of death, man, according to the judgment of the Most High, man. And you take pleasure in it, man. Like, you're proud while you're doing it, man. So proud you want mama to come see you. That shit is ridiculous and beyond me. You think it's a game, man. But it's easy to think it's a game when your body is whole. When you still got your job, when you still just going through life, and everybody telling you, yeah, fuck them Greek Millstone guys, man. Don't worry about them guys, man. Keep pushing the word, bro. Stay up, bro. It's easy to do that until the Most High take your arm away, till the Most High start killing your family off. Now, what if the Most High take your old ass mama out, man? That'll be on you. It'll be on you, Nas. Cause yeah, she sure did subscribe to that whole preach while you over there yelling on us, man. But you know, hey man, that'll be on you. Them guys that's under you, those pet monkeys that listen to you, man, it'll be on you.
Kind, cause to add another point, you have pleasure in it yourself, but also it says, not only do the same, but have pleasure in them that do them. Basically, the people that approve of it, mm-hmm. you know, your followers, mm-hmm. the people that follow you, man. The Lord gonna get y'all too, man. Subscribing to that madness, man.
Good.
You know?
Yeah, man. The Lord gonna deal with all you guys, man. All of you, Element, MAC-10, Avenger, Tried and Refined Camp as a whole. If you don't agree with what this nigga is doing, you better get the hell away from there. That's all I gotta say, because judgment gonna come on that camp as a whole, man. So you better get the hell away from that. Tell him to stop, try to talk him out of it, or whatever you can do. If you don't listen, go and get out of there, man.
Yeah.
Because when the Lord brings the judgment, it's going to happen. Yeah. You know?
Judging by their spirit, they ain't going to leave, you know?
Yeah, yeah. Y'all, like I say, that's why I called y'all a bunch of pet monkeys, man. You know what I'm saying? It's like Sakari's new pet monkey. It used to be Hakai. Now it's whoever that other nigga is. I don't care to know his name. But yeah, either way, Lord Will, you brought us edified. I want to give all praises to Yahweh,
Vashem, Yahweh Shai.
Double honors to the elders, the apostles of Great Millstone. And honors to you, brothers, who are out there doing the work in sincerity and in truth. Shalom.
Shalom.